Hey, what's up, rock stars? It's Rocks. Welcome back to the channel. All right, what are we talking about today, you guys? It is hot in Atlanta. Ooh, it is so humid out. Let's talk about the shooting in San Jose. Let's talk about Marjorie Taylor Greene. Let's talk about Texas once again. Something's wrong with y'all, governor. We're going to discuss the killing of Manuel Ellis, and we'll wrap it up with a Rona check-in. Let's talk about it. All right, you guys, so first story up, yet another mass shooting. I guess we did get a break, or at least there weren't any that the news was speaking of the last week or so, or maybe I just hadn't been doing a Let's Talk About It video, but once again, we have another mass shooting, this time at a rail yard in San Jose. Actually, they said that about 6:30 in the morning, shots rang out, and there was a complex of municipal buildings in San Jose, I guess downtown San Jose, and the sheriffs were called out. By the time they could get into the building, the gunman had killed himself. And that gunman would be 57-year-old Sam Cassidy. He shot colleagues in two buildings, they say, right around the time that the shifts were changing that morning. He shot 39 rounds and he killed 9 people. And like I said, by the time the deputies could get to him, he actually turned the gun on himself, did it right in front of them. They're saying that as he walked through the building, he seemed to specify exactly who he wanted to shoot. Because there were people that thought that he was going to shoot them, and he would tell them that I'm not going to shoot you. And then at the same time, while all this was going on at the rail yard, the authorities said that his house was burning down to the ground. Not sure how that happened, if he set it on fire or what, but they said that Cassidy hated his job, that he had been considered a disgruntled employee for many years. Back in 2016, when he had gotten back from vacation, there was a memo book that was found on him where he wrote out his hate for the VTA after his bags had been inspected by customs. He was returning from the Philippines, and he resented the VTA for that. They found books on terrorism, and that, yeah, he just hated where he worked, and that's the reason why they believe that he had a specific list of people that he wanted to kill. Now he's just left a whole bunch of very hurt people in his wake. People have died, families have been destroyed, and lives have been ruined because of this one person. So like all of the other shootings that we have had in the past and talked about in the past, our prayers go up for those families that have been affected, for that family of employees at that, at the VTA, I'm sorry, and for that community, because these kind of things always rattle you. Like I told you guys in the past, it seems that we're just going to hear more and more about these mass shootings. I mean, they happen daily, even if they don't get reported on. And I guess our next story should probably be about what's going on in Texas, kind of to keep this all cohesive. But yeah, it's prayers up for everybody that was affected there. Another group of people gunned down, prayers up for everybody there. Let's talk about what's going on in Texas. Now, just last week, I talked to you guys about Governor Abbott signing into law the heartbeat bill, where if you are pregnant, if you are further along, further than 6 weeks, if there's a heartbeat that is detected, I should say, if there's a heartbeat that is detected when you go to your doctor's appointment, you can no longer get an abortion. The heartbeat means that that is a living being inside of you, and that that fetus is now protected by this bill. We know it's a very controversial bill because most people don't know that they're pregnant at 6 weeks. So by the time they make it to the doctor's office, it's already too late. There aren't any options. Well, this week, I find out that Governor Abbott has decided that he's going to sign into law the permitless allowance to carry guns, open carry, which means that people who don't have permits are allowed to have a gun, and not only that, but wear it openly on their hip or however they choose to display it. I feel like he literally is taking it on back to the Wild Wild West, right? Anybody can have a gun? What the fuck is wrong with y'all, governor out there, Texas? What is happening? The conservatives have been fighting for this law for a long time. And they finally got it done. And like I said, Abbott does intend on signing it into law. Not quite sure why you would want just any old body walking around with a gun openly on their person when we have what I just talked about, mass shootings, when we have drive-by shootings, when we have intentional shootings, when we have random shootings. There's so many reasons that I can't understand why they would want something like this to happen, all in the guise of protecting the Second Amendment rights to bear arms. I mean, the interpretation of that amendment is just really it boggles me. Nobody is saying that you couldn't have a gun, but now we're saying any old body can just get a gun. All right. Now, of course, like I said, the conservatives, the Republicans are very much for it, and the Democrats, not so much. Also, the police department, the local law enforcement in Texas have said that they wished that even if people are able to carry their guns out in the open like that and not have permits for it, that they wish that this new bill would come with the requirement of going to class to learn how to handle a gun, because a lot of people don't even know how to handle a gun. They don't know how properly to handle a gun, I should say, and could end up hurting themselves, killing themselves, or somebody else unintentionally. They wish that there was something written into the law where, you know, a person would have to learn how to handle this. I just recently started shooting guns at the gun range with my husband, and it is, you just don't realize the power that is behind that gun. I mean, you see it, you know, you have a respectful fear of guns. Most people do anyway. But when you're holding it and you realize that this thing has so much power, I mean, you can literally kill somebody with this. You know, and that's a big responsibility. And I don't know if that responsibility needs to just fall on, if anybody should be able to just have that responsibility, you know. But they approved it. The House approved it, 82-62. And then the Senate approved the deal, 17-13. Very much so, it is happening in Texas. Child, I don't know what is going down in Texas, but they are making it a point to be very aggressive in their conservative values and views, and writing it into law. So frightening. Okay, I mean, I've been in certain states where they have open carry laws, but I would imagine that those states also had permits. You know, if you were going to be carrying it, that at least they had some sort of registration of your name and your information, just in case shit get a little dicey. And you know, but if we can just get anybody with a gun, I just feel like it's, I mean, it just doesn't feel like it's a good idea to me, okay? But maybe I'm not seeing it from all angles. So, people out there, and I'm not anti-gun. I am not anti-gun. So, I'm not saying that people shouldn't have guns and all this. I'm just saying that there has to be a way to do it where it makes sense. Just make it make sense for me. So, those of you guys who might see a different angle of this, you can explain that to me in the comments below, because I actually would like to hear the reasons why we would think that this is a good idea. You guys leave that down there and discuss. All right, you guys, next story up, your girl Marjorie Taylor Greene. If that name sounds familiar to you, it's because we've spoken about her at length in the past. Marjorie Taylor Greene is a representative in some small town out here in Georgia. I don't even know what the town is, y'all. I didn't even go check. I am sorry. Okay. But she is a representative in a small town, but she packs a lot of punch. She has a lot of power in her smallness, and continues to be a pain in the puss for the Republicans. Yet and still, with all of the way out shit that Marjorie Taylor Greene says, the Republicans continue to deal with her bullshit. Okay, now, Marjorie is the same woman who said that Nancy Pelosi should have a bullet in her head, that she committed treason, okay? She is the same person that said that the Sandy Hook school shootings did not happen. That was all set up and fake. She is the same person that said 9/11, that the Pentagon didn't really have a plane flown into it, that there was no traces of any plane. I mean, we've heard that one before. That's a more common a conspiracy that goes around. Marjorie Taylor Greene is also the same woman who said that the shootings at the Vegas hotel in the parking lot, she said that that was set up so that people would be so upset that they would turn to anti-gun activists and try to get rid of guns. So she said that that person that was there didn't work by himself. He had the help of possibly our government to really radically make some changes in the gun laws. Now, she didn't piss some folks off because she's talking about the Jewish people, and you know you can't talk about the Jewish people. You can't talk about the Jewish people. She's one of these ones who are anti-mask, okay? She feels like the mask is a political ploy and that we shouldn't be having to be forced to wear masks, that people should be able to walk around freely. Even during the whole entire pandemic, she was one of those people. Okay, so now she says, and I quote, "Vaccinated employees get a vaccination logo just like the Nazis forced Jewish people to wear a gold star. Vaccine passports and mask mandates create discrimination against unvaxxed people who trust their immune systems." Okay, now the reason why she is saying this, because there was an employer, I believe it was a grocery store, I'm not sure which one it is, but there was an employer who told their employees that if they were vaccinated, you know, fully vaccinated and can show proof, that they didn't have to wear a mask in the store, okay? That they could just have a little star that was placed on their ID badge to let people know that they have been fully vaccinated. All right, so that is why she said that the same way that the Holocaust victims were branded however they were, now we've got these stickers on the ID badge, and somehow she feels that that is comparable. Now she say all these outlandish things, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get rid of her. When she said Nancy Pelosi needed a bullet in her head, and she had the thing to say about the Sandy Hook, they wanted to put her out then, but the Republicans rallied around her. They kind of admonished her, told her that she needed to carry herself at a higher standard, yet and still she was still kept as a representative. Okay, they did take her off of some of the special committees that she was placed on, but other than that, she's still been there. Outlandish shit just come out, just be talking out the side of her neck, you guys. So, of course, the Republicans now, offended these Jewish people, and now what we gonna do about it? Well, Stephen Scalise, he said that, he put out a statement condemning it. Kevin McCarthy put out a statement condemning it. Okay, he said, "Let me be clear. The House Republican Conference condemns this language." Yet she remains there. You guys condemn it, but you keep this woman in place. Well, you guys know the Republicans do not want to show any dissension in their party right now. They have enough problems already, okay? So they don't feel like they would, they don't feel good about putting her out as she still kind of holds many of the ideals of the Republicans. At least she holds the ideals of Trump's base. she holds that, and that is what they are mostly concerned about, that they are going to, they are so afraid of upsetting Trump's base because they know that that is the only way that they can possibly do something in 2022, that they're going to continue to let her just be there, and say, "Oh, we don't, we condemn this type of thinking." But you got this woman as a representative. I mean, the word itself means that she is, she's standing for your party. So like I said, Marjorie Taylor Greene, she is a problem with power, okay? And she's going to continue to kind of, flirt with saying some inappropriate shit, because she knows that she can and nothing will happen to her. They're not going to censor her. They're not going to put her out. Nothing is going to happen. They're just going to, every time she does say something, they're just going to get on the news and be like, "We condemn this type of thinking," okay? They're so full of shit, you guys. So full of shit. It's amazing to me. And she just be so unbothered when you see her on the news. She just be smiling with her blonde hair and all that, They ought to be ashamed of themselves and quite embarrassed, if you ask me. All right, you guys. So I was watching the news last night, and they were talking about Manuel Ellis, who was killed in 2020. Okay, I didn't remember this story. I didn't remember the name. I was just like, you know, there's always been so many killings. It's a shame that you can't even remember all of the people that it happens that much. But evidently, Manuel Ellis was walking from a friend's house to the corner store, going to get him something to drink or whatever. Okay, earlier that day he had been at choir practice. He's a drum player, so he was practicing, and after that he went to his friend's house, and then he was walking to the store, and the police drove up to him. They said there was a short exchange of conversation between the two, and the next thing you know, the police jumped out and beat his ass. Okay, bum rushed him. They just really just beat him up. And of course the police did not have their body cams on. Surprise, surprise. But the video was still caught on tape. Okay, the beating was still caught on tape. And literally, I mean, they were beating the hell out of this young man. And they tased him a few times. Witnesses who were around said that he did not fight back. Well, he never had a chance to fight back. Literally, they were all over him. It was three men that were jumping on him, and three against one person, he's not going to win. So evidently, after the beating and the tasing, they had him restrained, and he was caught also on video saying that he could not breathe. They did not try to help him breathe, and he ended up dying. Then they lied and said that Ellis was seen trying to break into cars, okay, which was not the case. He was not trying to break in any cars, and still, even if he had been breaking in cars, that did not warrant the beatdown that they gave him. He was never resisting any type of anything, but they said that he actually attacked and punched at them, and that's why it got the way that it did. So a few minutes later, after they had restrained him, he died. And Tacoma, Washington was in an uproar. Yet again, we have a black man that have died at the hands of the police. Well, yesterday, Washington Attorney General Bob Ferguson announced charges against the three Tacoma police officers: Christopher Burbank, 35 years old, Matthew Collins, 38 years old. They face second degree murder charges, and Timothy Rankin, he's 32 years old. He faces a charge of first degree manslaughter, which is totally deserved, because when you see the video of how they was beating up that man, then the murder charges definitely make sense. So, I mean, I'm glad that these police are going to be tried for what they did. But, I mean, it's just senseless. Another young black man is killed by the police who did not do one thing. The family said that they want justice. And I can already tell that this is going to be a very large civil suit. They're going to get some money for this. But yet and still, the police need to be charged for murder because they killed that boy outright. You guys can go onto YouTube, and actually they have the video. I think the video is from like the people who had surveillance cameras like on their homes, like, you know, the Ring cameras and things like that. And you can see how the police just, I mean, it was awful. It was awful. So I was shocked when I saw that on the news last night, because I didn't remember the story at all. And that's just to show how many times this actually happens in America. Prayers up for the family. And I hope that justice is served. I hope that mother is able to get some sort of solace in knowing that the men responsible for killing her son will be tried. Will they go to jail? We'll see. You guys, a follow-up story on your boy Matthew Gates. Okay. His ex-girlfriend, they say, is cooperating with the feds now. And they expect her to be able to fill many of the holes in, you know, their investigation. Places where there's some gaps that they need some explanation. They feel like this ex-girlfriend is going to be the one to help him out, since she had been with him back in 2017 and has pretty much known about, you know, his whereabouts and what he's been doing since. And 2017 is right around the focal point of where they're concentrating their investigation, when they say that Matt Gates was fucking on young girls, all right, under 18. Not only was he having sex with young underage girls, but he also was paying women, underage women, to have sex with him. Paying for them to travel across state lines as he conducted his work business, putting him up in hotels and all of this. So the feds are on that ass. Now his friend who had been arrested, remember I told you guys about Joel Greenberg, he's entered into a plea agreement. So now he is also cooperating with the feds. And he told investigators that yes, he and Matt both engaged in having sex with underage girls, okay? And that they also paid underage girls for sex. So, you know, when your boy is in jail and he's facing all of these charges, I guess that's when the caged bird sings, all right? And of the 33 charges that were against him, 27 of those charges have been dropped, okay? So a lot of times in these federal investigations, it's just whoever talks first, all right? Now, if Matt Gaetz would have been the one to talk, then that would have, you know, hemmed his friend up, you know, more. But the fact that his friend decided to talk now, Matt Gaetz is on the defensive. And it looks like people are having a lot to say about what he did, what he's doing with these young girls and all that. Just sickening. Of course, he still maintains that he didn't do anything wrong. He did not have sex with underage girls and all that. We'll see how that plays out when your homeboy in jail is telling all the business. You know there's no honor amongst thieves, honey. Joel said, damn it, he gonna get some of these charges up off of him. And we'll also see what the ex-girlfriend has to say. This is not the young ex-girlfriend. I don't believe that this is the 17-year-old ex-girlfriend that they were talking about originally, but this is an ex-girlfriend of his. So we gonna keep our eye on it because this story is just interesting to me. You know, and all the perversions of these white men who think that they could just do whatever they want to do. I mean, they can do whatever they want to do. They've been getting away with it for so long. But every now and then, one of them get tripped up, and that's what's happening in this case. So, yeah, we'll keep our good eye on Matt Gaetz, and when I know more, you'll know more. And then lastly, you guys, the Rona check-in. Okay, let me just give y'all some numbers real quick, like... numbers are going down, even though this week they up higher than they was last week, because last week I remember saying that they were like at 569 or something. This week we are at, the deaths are at 1,339, and we have 27,620 new cases. Okay, so I believe both of those numbers are up, but they're saying still as a whole, the numbers are going down exponentially. 40% of the country is fully vaccinated. 50% have at least one dose, okay? And they pretty much are saying the people who intended on getting vaccinated have been vaccinated by now. So the people that haven't been vaccinated, they're gonna have to try some new push to get these people to get some shots in their arms. And child, they got all kind of things going on now. Did you guys see that they have the Vax-a-Million, the lottery in different states where you know, they're giving money, millions of dollars, $1 million to the lucky person who has been vaccinated. And I guess their name is entered into like the pool or whatever. In California, they have $10 million, they say, and they're going to give $1 million to 10 different people who've been vaccinated. There was another state that I saw that had, this woman had won the Vax-a-Million, and I think she had won like $7 million. Actually, my notes say Cali has $15 million to split amongst 10 people. So yeah, they're really trying to push, and it's different incentives. I saw that some baseball stadiums are giving them and saying that they'll give, you know, you seats to the game. They're saying that there are some travel agencies that are offering the vaccination and, you know, you getting a discount on flying wherever you want to go. They are giving vaccinations at the airports before you take off to wherever you're going. I mean, there's been like this huge push. They're just trying to figure out whichever way that they can get people. I mean, I'm just like, how are we supposed to get up on this Vax-a-Million if we didn't already had a damn vaccination? See, we ain't even gonna be able to get, you know, none of this money because we did what we were supposed to do. Now the people that was slacking, now they the ones that's getting rewarded for it. Interesting. We'll see what else they turn to try to get people out there to get their vaccinations. They say that President Biden is still trying to figure out where the virus began, that he is still asking or demanding information on what China knows about the coronavirus, if it was indeed man-made in a laboratory or if it came from a bat transferred over to a human. I think most people, I won't assume most people, but I know a lot of people believe that it is man-made. I think that that is also my feeling. And I think that it was a virus that got out of control some sort of way. And I don't know, I don't think the intention was for all these people to die, but that shit quickly spread. Or maybe it was the intention. People will say that it's, you know, when the country, when the world feels like it's too many people on there, that there are some ways that we have to get rid of some people. And maybe the coronavirus was a way for it to happen, you know, to cut down on the population. I mean, that just seems like such a horrible way. I would hope not. That's pretty much it, you guys. They're saying that if you had the Moderna, they already know for a fact that you're going to have to get a booster shot. I mean, I think that it's going to be at the point where it'll be like the flu shot. People will have to get the shot every year to make sure that they can keep the coronavirus off of them. This mask mandates is still giving people all these problems. They fighting over it. You know, here in Georgia, I was watching the news and they were talking about how some schools are still trying to have this mask mandate. And now that the mask mandate has been lifted, that there are parents who are upset that their kids have to go to school with masks on. I just be like, do you guys just like to fight and argue? Okay, what does it hurt for you to wear a mask? I just don't get why it's so politicized of wearing this mask. This is a health reason, not a political reason. It's not a statement, okay? It is you trying to protect yourself and others from getting a potentially deadly virus. And so I'll never understand why people are so against masks, you know? But yeah, so that's pretty much it, you guys. It's a lot going on in the world today. All right, you guys, that is it. Let me get off of here and get on back to work. The lunch break is over. Make sure that you rate, comment, and subscribe to the channel. I'm It's Rocks. The channel is It's Rocks, and everything else I do will be in the bottom bar. Happy Memorial Day to all the rock stars out there. I hope you guys have a good time. Outside is open responsibly. Okay, but have a good time celebrating with your friends and family, okay, and make sure that you're safe as well. I'm planning on having a good weekend myself, okay? I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful rest of your day, and I plan on doing the same. Till next time, rock stars. Bye.